today, not one, not two, but three different typography text effects that you can do right now in Adobe Illustrator. They're sure to spice up your typography, so let's get right into it. Now, the first text effect is a neon typography design with some handy stroke techniques that you might not be aware of. So firstly, of course, we need some text, and I'm using a nice bold thick font from the family Aileron. Now we're going to need to outline the text and then ungroup the lettering, and you're soon going to see why. But I want to have the lettering touching ever so slightly, so just nudge each character until they're touching at the edges. Okay, so now select all of your characters and then hit Command or Control X to swap the color fill over to a stroke. Now if you look closely, you can see the stroke outlines actually overlap and run into each other. This isn't going to be ideal for the design, so let's head into the Pathfinder panel and unite the entire section of the typography. Now that's looking better already, but we still need to make some changes in the stroke panel. So firstly, add a round cap in case you want to have your typography cut anywhere along the path, and then also use the round join, but importantly, change the design so the stroke is aligned on the outside. Now we can increase the stroke weight, and you'll see how neat that is already looking. But let's go ahead and add a gradient to the stroke itself. So select the stroke, and then in the color palette, add a gradient to the stroke. So now it's time to choose each color for the nodes on your gradient, and I'm going to be using three color nodes for this design today. So as often is the case, we're going to apply the effects to the typography in the Appearance panel. And once you have it open, click the stroke layer and duplicate it in the top right fly down menu. Now click the lowermost layer and increase the stroke weight to around this kind of amount. It's now time to add a Gaussian blur to this thicker layer. Your blur might look pretty pixelated, especially if your design is quite large, so increase the document raster effect settings that you can find here, and that will probably smoothen out most blur effects. So that was the first of three typography designs today, and you can really have some fun with this one. But let's move on to design number two. This technique works very well in handwritten and calligraphy style typography, and again, outline your text and then ungroup it as well. There are two crucial techniques for this second design, and for the first one, I will copy the A here with Command or Control C, and then select the first two letters. I'm going to use the minus front option in the Pathfinder panel. So then with Command or Control F, I will paste that A exactly in the same position it was copied from. So now I can nudge the S over somewhat, and that easily reveals a nice effect for hand lettering. So secondly, you can take the pen tool and manually draw in a section that we're then going to cut into the typography. So the crucial step for this technique, however, is that we can complete a non-destructive workflow function in the Pathfinder window. So once you have your shape, press V for the selection tool and then hold down Shift to select both the character and the shape. In the Pathfinder window, hold down the Alt Option key and then use the minus front option. This creates a compound selection, which is very, very handy. We can then use the group selection tool to select the shape itself, or we can use a direct selection tool to edit the anchor points individually. Now, both of these techniques can be used in tandem to create some very neat hand lettering, and it's going to add that finishing touch to your typography. But let's take a look at the third and the final typography technique in Illustrator today. Now the knockout typography effect is really, really great for things such as posters and brochures, but I'm going to show you some handy techniques and steps that will elevate your workflow to the next level. So I have the thickest version of Aileron available, and then I'm going to press M for the rectangle tool to create a rectangle to fit my text over the top of. The typography needs to be in the front of the rectangle, and then I'm going to use the eyedropper tool to sample the white from the artboard. Now I like to bring the rectangle close to the edges of my text for the knockout text effect, as I think that does work best in most situations. So then, select both the text and the rectangle, and bring up the Pathfinder window one more time. So again, by holding down the Alt Option key, we can use the minus front option, which is going to allow the text to be 100% editable. If we just click minus front without using the Alt Option key, nothing happens. So do make sure to hold down the Alt Option key when you use this process. This is going to allow us to change the text itself, as well as the font, even though the text is cut into the shape. Now you can then use your knockout text on just about anything you want to, but it does often work really well on black and white photography, and this instance is no exception. Now if you want to change the color of the rectangle, you can use the group selection tool to select the rectangle and then change the color from there. But that was the third and the final way to spice up your typography in Illustrator. Which one was your favorite today, and did you actually learn something? Be sure to click the video on screen now for yet more graphic design content, and do subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.